You know it, Tractor fans. That's right, we are back. A little later in the afternoon of where we left off. I believe this is episode 17, but what do I know? I'm losing track. But anyway, welcome. Ringwoods Map Farm here. The idea is to take everybody through an entire season from the beginning of February. 2 February. We are in the second day of April. And if you're familiar, at least with my map, our months only last 2 days. So tomorrow will be May 1st. Bunch of new activity. Anyway, we are about ready to finish up our soybeans on the row crop. I was back here checking the seed, checking our air. And I thought this would be a good place to pick up, good look at the planter. And if you are a new viewer, I appreciate you tuning in. Got the case 400 still. Let's, before we climb aboard, let's take a look at the map. And well, let's look at our forecast. What do we got? May 1st, nothing but sun. All right, here we are. We wrapped up this field here in the last episode. Well, most part, there was a few strips that I put in with the Massey, and I got out here. After that, I did put in my in-rows and took care of this little section over here. So we are gonna finish our row crop soybeans here, and then I got another surprise we are gonna put in full row soybeans. And I was just back preparing another tractor. Yes, yet another one. We're gonna hook on, and so let's finish this up, then get to this, and then everything will be planted. So all right, let's get going here. Get the air on, and we'll be set, ready to get some more in. And here comes the air, put her down. And we're underway again. Even though it may have looked big on the map, it will certainly not take long. This 48 row John Deere planter should be able to get out of here in all a few rounds, get back to the barn, and grab another piece of equipment. Get done in time, we'll take you down to the store. I promised you a little bit of goodies in the last episode. We ran a little long, we did not get down there, so I won't make the promise today, but that is the outlook, what we want to accomplish. Always try to find a little bit more fun in every episode. Rolling along just nicely here. We should have enough seed and fertilizer to get done here, so we don't want to bring the truck back out. wasn't a bad turn. Landed it pretty much right on our mark. All the young kids out there, we love to tune in, watch how some of this equipment operates. This is about as close to real life as you're gonna get. Sounds, the actions, what these tools can do. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Especially three kids who I decided to start producing these little videos for, namely Kennedy, Reagan, and Calvin, my three grandkids. I know they watch them. They don't want to miss anything. And to any other kids that tune in, I appreciate you. One round in. Stay on that mark on that turn. We'll get her. Grab a little radio here. Let's change the station. Same guy. There's a little country. Classical. Shut it back off here and make our turn. Keeping a close eye. On that fertilizer. Seed looks like it's gonna hold out. Fertilizer I'm a little nervous about. I think will determine it. Alright, see if we can find something again along here. Oh. Not gonna get a whole lot of tunes here. Our little country. I think this is probably better listening than listening to me talk all the time. This might even be better. Take you in cab for a second. Left on that fertilizer. I don't believe we are going to make it. About a round and a half, actually. Certainly not going to make it on the fertilizer. The seed's okay, but it means nothing if we don't have any fertilizer. So what we'll probably do is pack it up here, bring the full row down here, fill in that one last gap before we head over to the field, which is directly in front of us. It's the one that'll have to go in next. Just hoping we can make it to the end here so we don't have to plant some half round or something. So we are coming to the end of our journey with the 48 row planter for this season. I hope you watched enjoyed watching this thing work. I always love farming with it. Alright, we got a whole bulk of seed here. There we are. We're not going to make that last round, so we will bring in the other one, finish that. So let's fold this thing up, get her back to the barn. I always forget which wing wants to go up first. There we go. Chose right this time. Just a little action. See the disc blades in there and the seed drop chutes. Of course, the filler wheels go on the other side. Loving the Case 400. Sounds so good. All right, here comes the fold up. The hydraulics pull it on in, and at the same time, it's coming back. Go in on the lock here. See those two little locking arm mechanisms come down. And up we come. And we are locked. There we are. Alright, let's get this big rig on home, shall we? Been fun farming with this field off to the right hand side. There is the one we're going to come back and do next. Whoop, I put the sign and I have to come back and put that up for the county. Don't want to get in trouble there. Off to the side, if you look. Past episodes, we kind of explored the this little pond there. Once again, I must thank the creator, Stevie, who's a brilliant modder, put this map together. It's just detailed everywhere. I'll say it again, probably easily the best map that I've ever played, and I have played quite a few of them, so. There's the farm. Coming on home in the case. We're gonna go right to the wash bay. In fact, that's up front, so let's just, we'll come in the front entrance and skip the back. Gotta get up to the front anyway. Once again, thank goodness there's no traffic here to get in our way. Gotta take the Massey home there. Just spotted that. Pull that home, get that washed up, put it away. The worst bay. Got a run over pond off to the right. Alright. That'll do it for that. Wash that up after we get everything in. Alright. Let's head out to next surprise I've got for you. And there it is, right in front of you. Now, granted, we did plant with, or drove a John Deere. It was a 9620R John Deere. It's what they call an Eagle Edition. 1500 horsepower. We were in the field earlier. This is a straight up 9RX, and we decided to go with this for the less compaction when we're planning, and we put on the extra tanks, which we would have needed just that last bit there. Would have had a little extra fertilizer, we could have put it all in. Alright, so this is the rig here we're going to be running. This is a solid row planter. You have seen this, and this is referred to as a drill and not a planter. Just got done with a planter. I just got everything filled up. We will keep this thing in the field for days for as much capacity as this holds. And then with the extra fertilizer tanks, we won't have to come back in. But yeah, I just filled up with seed and fertilizer. So we are ready. Jump in here. Gotta get that pipe in first. go. All shut. And, let's sneak out the back door if we can make this turn. Yeah, I guess we'll take the same path that we just came. Walk that way. Pretty easy making that turn. That'd be a little more difficult. But... listen to that horsepower kick in. This is a big rig to pull here, especially when loaded. Got a lot of weight in that seat. There's a good shot of those extra tanks up front. Where you for sure do not want to encounter any traffic. Getting over is quite difficult. We just hope the road we have all to ourselves, at least till we get to the field. If you're wondering, all that movement, this computer does follow my eyes, so wherever I'm looking when we're in cab, the computer will follow. So that's how that's controlled right there. All right. Comes the big spread. Hydraulics right there controlling, if you can see that. Jump to the other side. She's going down. Remember, this is our turbine, wind turbine on the back. It blows all the seed and the fertilizer right up to our gangs, and in they go. All right. Make sure we do indeed have the right field. Yes, we do. We certainly don't want to forget that little patch. Let's get her on. We're gonna adjust our speed here, our cruise. Don't want to run it too fast, too hot. Let's run her down about 7. And away we go. Stop for a second because I think we may have aired. Possibly aired here. Yes, we did. We are gonna switch this real quick. We're gonna make this. All right, let's try this again. Swing on it. Instead of following this curve, this contour, we're going to try to keep our line straight. Instead of following that, then we're able to just come back and fill in that little gap a lot easier without having to adjust each time we make a pass following that curve. So, I'm going to run this straight if you were wondering. Shot of the 9RX coming at you with the dual tanks. Is he doing his job? A little mulch up to the surface with all the action going on front here. Bit richer dirt on this side of the field. I'm not tearing up quite as mulch the surface. dark, deep, rich, almost black soil. A little wide here. Jot in this little section first, then get back to the big full rows. It comes down a little bit faster than the planter did. A little save here. Our guide once again. Put in a dual end roll on this end. It's got a lot of trees, it'll be easier turning around with a double. And here we can be able to pick it up and set it back down. Now, are running smooth. This whole outfit is really nice to operate. Should turn this tractor actually into our full-time planning tractor, especially for this big drill. Not only we have the horsepower, but we have the extra capacity tanks that really gonna make a difference of keeping us out in the field. Try to swing it and square it off. Actually, you know what? To make it easier, we will make a whole round on this end. So if you have joined us from the very start, episode 1, back in February, you have seen us come through almost the entire planting season at this point. We've planted cotton, oats, barley, wheat, grass, and now, of course, we've got our corn, and now our soybeans, and this field is the last remaining bit of ground that has not been planted, so no more planting for the rest of the season. So hopefully you've enjoyed this portion of it. I think if the kids are loving this, then we find another map, which is going to be very tough, comparable to what we have here. We may do another season and a whole different map. But right now, we've still got a long ways to go. Harvest coming up. Still got a lot of things to see here on this map. A lot of things to do. Tend to the cows and the horses and the pigs. Thinking about putting in a sheep pen. Always like sheep. Gonna have to manage our greenhouses here fairly soon once this is in. So many things that we can't forget to leave out. I'm trying to make this turn here. Don't happen to go back. There we go. We got her. Bump her back up here. Let's take a quick look. And we want to see. Click on another one, and then back here. So this field is 36 down there in the bottom left-hand corner. It shows you 36, almost 37 acres. So if you've ever wondered what 37 acres looks like, well, you're seeing it right here. Get a save in here. I'm going to come back to this field. Well, this is not a good one because it's broken up. So that's not going to help us a whole lot. We did start with the 80-acre field. Then we walked down to 40. Now we're down to a 36. Our fields keep getting a little bit smaller. And if you notice, you'll see that the liquid fertilizer has not kicked in. We're running dry, of course, in these containers. We've got the back two are seed, and the front two are the dry fertilizer boxes, and we're running liquid fertilizer up front just in case we run out. I seriously doubt either one. Still running 84% fertilizer and 92% of soybeans, and that's what makes this huge box easy to stay out and keep in the field. All right, now we're gonna make that swing a little bit easier. Is probably the one regret that I would have with this map. So if we had a few more acres, especially when you're running this kind of equipment, you can get everything planted fairly quickly. But at the same time, the map is so small, medium size, I guess you'd say, that it makes it unique. Now let's see if we can't get this little bit left here. Everything is just running so smooth. Barely hear those gangs go up. Not gonna be wide enough here, not quite. There's a good shot of them going down. Wow, we may be able to cheat that over and actually get this. Not quite. Boy, just the tiniest of strip remaining over there. We had to go back to the other end anyway, so. We can just about get on with our full strips. So again, these are a full row. Each one of those little wheels presents a row of soybeans going in. So it is a full row. And like what we just did with the planter. Those are row crop soybeans that we put in. But we wanted to use this too. Again, no matter where I turn my head, all the way around, my computer has an eye that it's eye tracking. Some of the newest technology. So when you do go in cab, you have to kind of remain a little still. This, my head's turning, it gets a little jumpy. Well, we've got a little bit of time here. What May is going to bring us. Our grass will need to be mowed, winrowed, and picked up. We're gonna have to refill our bins with grass. Make sure the animals have enough throughout the season. And I believe we got our grass in early, but we'll be able to get 3 cuts off of it. And the first cut should be our next episode. This is making it really tough to turn here. Only one row, one end row. Get her spun around here. probably gonna run over that hour video time. In the past, I do try to keep it anywhere from 45 minutes to an hour. I'd rather produce several videos rather than one lengthy 2-3 hour video. I think it's just easier watching. That way it can be broken up into actual real time that we're used to with TV series and whatnot being 30 minutes or an hour long, and that's why I try to keep them this long. So we are approaching that. We probably are going to go over it, so I apologize, but we will get all of our soybeans, as promised, done in this episode, so we can move on. And when you join me next, it will be May 1st. I take everything back, gotta get it washed up, everything put back in its place. It won't get presented again for a while. Of course, we'll be back out planting wheat again before too long, and so forth. But more or less, we have harvest season to look forward to at this point. You notice this one's a little bit easier to navigate turning wise versus that 48 row planter, which is just a massive thing to turn around and try to hit those end rows in here. A little bit easier. Looks like we've got about a round over there. I think we'll get it in a half a round. And then of course we'll take that last little bit from that prior field, that last little strip. And we will be done for the day. As well as done with the spring planting for this year. Hopefully you've enjoyed yet another tractor to see in operation. You see one close, like I said, the 9620. This one obviously is very, very similar. This is just the 9RX. See, always a different little bit of variety in everything that I try to showcase. There's the big RX. Up we go. Start our final round. I think we might still have a shot to run down to the store kind of teased you last episode thinking we'd get time for it, and we did not. This episode, I've thrown it out there. I would rather not tease you again. You know, we'll have all kinds of time, possibly in the next episode, do a lot more fun stuff, but I think we'll still sneak down there. Maybe we'll even revisit it the next episode as well. Showcase it in two episodes in case somebody missed it. But I think that's what we'll do. This big tractor will have to go down and tell them that thinking about just buying this one and putting her in the barn. I think this is an excellent planting tractor. Like I said, the tracks are less compaction on the soil. That compaction is not the greatest on a normal wheel situation. I think we've got room enough in the barn for this one. This one seems to handle a little bit smoother than the other one that we had, the Eagle 9RX. If you remember that one, I'd love to tell you which episode, but I cannot. It wasn't too long ago. We had both tracked vehicles out there for tillage. That's when we were using the big 9620 Eagle Edition. This one seems to just have a little bit better stability control. I was looking over there to see if we could squeeze in one of those places without having to fold this thing up, but I don't think that's possible. If I were to fold her up and then drop her back out again. Go down again and percent of seed still allow, or 84 on seed and 67 on fertilizer. So yeah, we could have stayed out in the field, field after field before this thing runs out. Hopefully we'll be able to get that last little strip in one pass with this, but I'm thinking not quite. I've looked at it already, and I don't think this is quite white enough, so. Alright, let's fold her up here real quick. Pop over that other field. Here we go, 36 acres put in. Pretty quick time. There, we're all folded. Stay in the field. Less obstacles over here. What do you guys think? Think we can make it in one pass? I don't think so. I'm thinking we are going to be just shy. Alright, so we're going to have a solid row on this end versus the row crop right off to the right. That won't bother the combine in the slightest. Alright, let's check our progress. There we are. Full, complete field in. This is the last little strip we've got. See how the fertilizer, now we're a little weak. I think on the fertilizer, it does need rolling. One issue that we could probably take care of next episode along with grass cutting. Basically, when it's saying it's roll, it needs rolling, it just wants a little bit more compaction of the soil for the seed. But we'll get that done. Add a higher rate of fertilizer, and we'll be in good shape. Alright, just coming up on just about that hour time of video. I'm not sure if that bothers the viewers that I go long or short or whatever. But that's just my view on it, is trying to keep it right around that hour time. Alright, make our final pass. This would have been a nice little strip for the Massey Ferguson still hooked up to the Kinsey. Could have brought that out here. Why not? Let's just put her in and be done with it. Is our end, folks. Well, off. Folder up. Okay. While this goes up, we'll check. And we are completely seated to everything. So, all right. Time to go on home. That did not take us long at all. Still have 82% seed left in the box. Which just means now we've got a lot more to clean out. Get the soybeans out of there. Cleaned out. Next time we'll probably use this is for weed again. Keep running this straight. Just hope we don't run into any traffic like normal. Take this obviously to the worst bay. Planter's in the way right now, but just kind of wait in line and move everything up, get a wash, put away. Yeah, this is 9RX. Has a little bit better characteristics than the other one that we had. I think you, in past previous episodes, realized that I do prefer the normal wheel tractors versus these articulated. And what I mean articulated, it's right there how it turns, right in the middle. A little bit jumpy and harder to steer at some points. All right, basically 2 days to get our corn and our soybeans all in. They're getting with big equipment. Makes it a lot easier. You better come wide here up to the horse bay. Bay. Okay, well, as promised, let's take a quick trip to the store. So I've got a few things I need to show you, especially the red lovers, my age case. I understand they put out a whole line of tractors that something new introduced here. This is an Alice Chalmers, actually two of them. One thing that you could always spot on Alice is these diamond shaped tires that no one ever else had. They were predominantly on an Alice Chalmers. Some orange power, so to say. We will have to take one of these out and see what it's got. Couple of those in. What do we got here? We got a 80, 70, and the 70, 80. An 80, 70? So an 80, 70, and then a 70, 80. Okay. So these are older schools. You don't see much of these at all around anymore. But, the combines, also from Alice Chalmers, were called the Gleaner. And in short time, with harvest season coming up, I'm sure our store's going to put out a whole lineup of harvesters that we'll be able to check out and see every kind, and including what's called a Gleaner, and that comes from Alice Chalmers as well. So on to our red display here. Some great tractors. This is a 1086. It is. It's 1086. My favorite IH of all time. And I had one. It was a 1066. Just a great, great tractor to drive around. Love that tractor. Very stylish, but all these are, call them old school. A lot of these you still see today. This is, called the White Stripe International. So, if you don't know, International, which is used to be International Harvester, and then there was a separate company called Case. Well, Case came along and bought out International Harvester. So if you see that little symbol right there, that is the I and the H. So Case bought out International Harvester, and it became just one brand. And that is where history used to lie. So Case, I might have to find a Case in the store, an old Case. And again, it was its own brand, and it came along and bought out International Harvester. And that's why they retain the same red, even though Case takes the front nameplate. So that's the history on that. So 1086, and then we had a Hydro 186. The Hydro stood for the transmission type and the gearbox. So no different sizes. Of course, this is open station, what they call them. This is the cab model. Still the white stripe. So that was the 1086. I wish I could give you some definites on horsepower, but I don't. Next steps up to a 1586. A little bit more horsepower. Indeed. Of course, the grills were always famous. IH. So they held that line and just stepped up. Okay, so we have got the white stripe. And this is called basically the red. The white stripe International 786. We'll step down here to a 986 cab version. So we've got quite a lineup. So we've got a 786, a 986. 1586, the Hydro 186, and the 1086. So that was obviously the 86 series, and they also had a 66 series, and I wish I could put my hands on one of those. It was the 1066, which was one of my favorite tractors. Over here, we've got the 1486, and we're back to the red. Didn't we have a 14? Okay, so we got a 1586 white stripe and a 1486 red. So let's just hop in. Let's choose one. You know what? Let's take the. If you'll notice here, this one is basically it isn't quite a rollover protection system, what they used to call ROPS. There is no glass in this. As you see, it is just the frame, and they used to come like that as well. Of course, all the others are glass, but that was basically an open air. The sun didn't get to you. So let's take 1086. Oh. to jump in the other one over here. There we go. There's a little noise to it. Just look at the back end. It's weird. A little bit different. Things have a 3-point, but one on the left here got a few more valid connections. So that's what you also got. More connection for bigger tools or high valves. This is a straight pipe exhaust. Taking stuff for a test drive. Well, we are just gonna have to buy the 9RX. That'll be a big purchase. There's our guy right there, Stevie's. Once again, the mod creator of this wonderful map. So he's got his own store. All right, so there was our little surprise right there. The whole line of IH equipment. From the red line to the white line, and I'll have to ask them if we can't get a 66 series tractor out there instead of just all the 86s. Look for them to bring in a 1066 used one, and they probably right down here snatching that up, putting it on the farm just for old time's sake. Look, driving around. There's one that was called a 1066 wheat plant. I have a model of great big front wide tires, almost flotation tires, open station, of course, but the bus tractors, never had the privilege of driving, so of course we always wanted a little bit bigger 1486, never laid our hands on one, 1066, sure covered some acres. There we are. End of April coming to a close here. So are we with this episode. I hope everybody enjoyed it, especially that last little part where we got to show you a little UIH line. So instead of running over, I appreciate everybody's time. And hopefully you'll come back. This is again. Watch the continuation of this season here on Ringwoods. Until then, I will see you on the next episode, and thanks for tuning in.